Alright, what's up? Oh, sorry, I gotta set my camera up. Let me put this. I should've got this situated. Like, alright, so, what's up, boys? It's your boy, DJ, back with another reaction video. And, Fall K, that's the title of Stanley's Animation. Subscribe, he's a good animated story. He got caught 4K. So, I wanna know, doing what? You know what I'm saying? So, we gonna find out in 3, 2, 1. Oh, and by the way, she has a belt, so I'm guessing, like, two things he got caught doing. So, because he got a belt, right? So, there's two things she probably got caught doing. Smoking or doing something he wasn't supposed to do, or or eating in a room that he's not supposed to be eating. All right, and I'm guessing his mom or whoever caught him with the belt tells it all. So we're gonna start. 3, 2, 1, start.
I hear my bag unzip, then silence. I feel her pull something out of my backpack.
Huh?
And then she says,
cigarettes.
Stanley?
Uh-oh, I think my prediction was correct.
Growing up, we're always taught to be the bigger person. Turn the other cheek. If someone does something to you, it doesn't mean that you have to get even with that person. And I actually agree to that. It's a good core rule to have as a human being. However, just like every other rule, it has its limitations. For example, if someone eats my leftovers in the fridge and I see it, I'm just disappointed. Like, you were really that hungry that you didn't see the big S on top of the box, my G? But if someone punches me, I gotta bury that nigga. Like, what? Mama ain't raised no bitch. Which brings us to my neighbors, Eric and Cody. They lived right next to us. And when I say right next to us, I mean right next to us. We lived in a duplex, and we were literally breathing down each other's necks 100% of the time. So naturally, my brother and I became close friends with the kids across from us, to the point where we went to school together, played in the backyard together, ate together. These were the homies. But don't get it confused. Even though we were in a duplex next to each other, that does not mean we were doing the same financially. They had way more games and consoles than we ever had. How do I know this, you ask? Well, it all started when Eric and Cody came over and visited our home. It was just like any other day. And in our house, we didn't have too many forms of entertainment. You know, we had a DVD player and, you know, a TV. I think we had a radio. I don't know, bro. I'm from the trenches. We played Uno with ramen packets on concrete. When Eric and Cody come over, we would usually just watch cable TV. But today, we watched SpongeBob the movie, because we had it on
SpongeBob
DVD. My brother and I loved this movie. We watched the movie like 4 times a day. By the time we started watching the movie with Eric and Cody, it was already pretty late, but we tried to get through it anyways. But all of a sudden, through the sliding doors leading to the backyard, we hear, Eric, Cody, it's time to come back. It's getting late. As we started walking them out of our house, they started begging my brother and I for the DVD so that they can watch the movie at their house. Only problem is, we don't want that. Without that movie, I knew I was going to spend most of my time pouring hot water on an anthill in my backyard. There's nothing to do here. After like 3 minutes of them just solid begging, we cave in and give them the DVD. And they walk back to their house, but my brother wasn't happy about it.
Man, why we let them take the CD? You know they could have just came back tomorrow.
Bro, it'll be fine. Nothing's happening to the DVD in one night.
See, this is why I don't let you make decisions. Always making the right choices and
where are you going?
I'm gonna play with the fans, yelling it without breathing or something.
Dummy.
Don't come in my room.
We go to sleep. Next day comes, and my brother and I are waiting for Cody and Eric, but both of them don't come outside. We go to sleep. Wait another day, go back outside, and Cody and Eric are still not there. 3 days, 3 whole days go by. We do not hear or see them niggas not one time. I thought we turned into Helen Keller. Come on, man. Let's just take it back. One more day. If they don't got it in one more day, we can go over there. Go to sleep. Next day comes, nothing again. Man, let's jump these niggas.
What? Yes, please. No,
they are 4 for 4 for not giving us this DVD.
Thank you.
They think they Wendy's. Was that a pun? Wendy's hands go across their face, they fry. Please stop. We go to the...
No ad, not dogs are...
Go to the front door of Eric and Cody's house, and their father answers the door. Not their mom. Our whole tone changes.
Just took his CDs. Hey, why you looking so awesome?
Is Eric and Cody home?
We let them borrow our VHS DVD.
Oh, yeah, I know exactly where that is. Give me one second. Homie comes back like 3 minutes later, hands us the DVD. When we got home, we just left the DVD on the TV stand. What we should have done is watch the DVD immediately, because when we did go to watch the movie that night, I put the DVD in the DVD player, and it would start playing, but then it spit out the DVD.
My man, what's going on?
I push the DVD back in, it spins for a little bit, then it spits back out. I take the DVD out again, because by this point, I'm confused. I flipped the DVD...
Put a crown on the live button. I'm too mad to talk. You can watch the rest of the video. I am, because I want to see what happens next.